Hello everyone.
I wanted to come on here and do this flip through of this Chunky Monkey journal that is absolutely beautiful, I think, and I hope Yvonne likes it. I was so excited when she asked me to do a swap with her, and I put together this journal. I just tied it with some beautiful lace that she can use, or she can change the closure. This thing is a monster. I think I might have put too much lace in it for her, but I do shabby chic. I didn't realize she didn't like a lot of lace, but she can always take some of it out. This is one of my favorite images, and I had used it on a couple journals. And as I posted it on Instagram, she had commented that it was also her favorite image, so I made it a point to use it on the cover of her journal. So there is this beautiful fabric that I put on the cover, and I just sewed it onto some cardstock. I think it's two layers of cardstock. There is a doily here with this rosette, and you can get these from Denise's shop at A Tattered Dream. And then I just put this butterfly that I coffee dyed, and then added this little flatback pearl, and then there is some vintage crocheted lace behind it, and it is just so squishy, but you can't get it closed very much. I hope I'm not too close. I really just filled it full of stuff. I had to stop, and then I kept adding stuff, and I had to go back and stop again. So she'll have to take some of this stuff out. There is a lot of different designers in here. I went through my box of bits and bobs, as she says, and I just got a lot of my extra digis out that I had stored over the years, and so I don't remember where a lot of these come from, so you'll just have to forgive me. But I tried my hardest not to put any Artie Mays in this journal, and some of it just had to go in here, but I tried really hard not to. And you might say, well, why did you do that, Lisa? Well, because Yvonne has more Artie Mays than Artie Mays has, okay? If you have seen any of her videos, you know that, because she just does. Recently, she did like a little She Shed tour, and she has Artie Mays digis like stacked up where she's just fussy cutting them out for her journals. And she literally does. She's got more Artie Mays than Artie Mays does. So I was like, don't put Artie Mays in her journal. But there was a few times I just had to, because they just looked perfect. And right there's one of them. It just went perfect with the page, and it just kept popping out to me, and I was like, I've got to use that there. So yeah, I just had to. But this is some wallpaper, a digital that I put there, and I used some of the fabric from the front, and I just made a pocket on the front and the back. And so there's a guest check here. I think this is my porch prints, but I could be wrong. Not sure where that come from. That might be also, like I said, this is from everywhere. This is Tina's Shabby Dabby Doodon, so is this. And then there's a doily here. This is vintage stationery. And then this is antique music paper. And all the pink paper is avocado dyed. And then I used three strips of the fabric from the front cover, and I made three ruffles to put in the journal. And then there is some pages, I think there's two pages from the Ideals magazine that I put, and I just love the Ideals magazine. And then here, which I'm not gonna take everything out, but there is some vintage, antique ephemera in there for her. I know she does not have a lot of that, so I put some stuff in there for her, and I just used a, I'm trying to reach around this tripod, Edith Holden book page, and I sewed it into an envelope and then just added some sari silk along the front. And this is a vintage book page from, The Better Homes and Garden. I think it's the gardening book. And then a lot of the pages I folded up and made a pocket. So I just sewed them. And then I just stuffed them full. And I mean full. I couldn't quit. And I put coffee dyed paper doilies. I did not embellish them because I'm going to let her do that. Because I had to stop. They were getting so full. I put some of my wallpaper journaling cards in there, and they're sewn around. And then some more vintage stationery. There's a lot of vintage stationery in here because she had seen a purchase I had made of a bunch of vintage stationery, and she just loved it. And so I've added some throughout. This is some piano. This is antique piano paper roll, and I have sewed it around some antique music paper from the 1800s, and so she can write on that. This is from Diane Shaw, which is Shawcraft One on YouTube, and she is Mo Barn Door on Etsy. She has some beautiful digital kits. And then this is a digital vintage calling card from Cassie, who is Dust of Roses. Totally lost my train of thought there. This is just a vintage recipe page, and I just added some lace. Of course, you can always cut that off, Yvonne, if you don't want that lace on there. And some of the pages are from Paper Studio. I wanted to add some pretty designer pages. And then this is another Ideals book page, which is all floral, so pretty. This is an embossed vintage stationery. Forgive me for having problems with my speech today. I'm having a hard time with my headaches. And this is some of my vintage ephemera, and I just scanned it, copied it, and I just kind of made it look more vintage and distressed around it. And then here's another one of mine, and I did the same thing. I just kind of made it look vintage. I've scanned it so the back is kind of white, but that gives her somewhere to write on, and I just made it look really vintage after I, of course, you know, copied it. Here's another piece of authentic ephemera. And then this is the digital, and I don't know where that come from. I think I do, but I don't want to say because I'm not sure. And then this is just out of a book. And I don't remember which one. Just a piece of ephemera. Book page, sorry. And some yellow lined paper. And then I made two of the flips, the Rita flips. And then I like to add these little envelopes sometimes. And the little envelopes, I got this idea from Lori Girl on the Ridge. She adds them to all kinds of things, but I like to add them to the flips sometimes instead of the butterflies. And Yvonne loves butterflies, so I found all kinds of vintage butterfly things. And this is some book pages, very old. So I added this in there for her. She can do whatever she wants with. Get it in there. And then this is just an old book page, and this is about American patchwork quilts. So I wanted to add that in there. And then this is a printable for a butterfly, like a catalog card. And then I think this come from Mrs. Coggs. beautiful. And I can't remember if this is an encyclopedia or dictionary, something like that. This is one of my favorites, and it's the only piece I had, but it is vintage wallpaper. Is that not gorgeous? I don't know if you can see it. It's so light and pastel. It is my one of my favorites. And so I gave that to her. I just tucked it in the side of that fabric ruffle. This is the center of the signature. And I just made two large journaling cards. And this is out of some of Tina's paper, background paper, from one of her kids. And I can't remember which one it is right now. Of course I can't. And of course there's some more of the, of course these are sewn, and I just added some more of the doilies. And then Yvonne can just decorate it up however she likes. Like I said, I just couldn't do anymore. There's another flip out that she can make a pocket or just tuck something in. She likes to tuck stuff. So I gave her plenty of tucks. And here's another Rita flip with some more little envelopes and of course some more butterflies. So here is another beautiful butterfly. It's got all kinds of butterflies on it. This one is a recipe page. And another one of the catalog cards of the butterflies. And another one of Mrs. Cogs. I'm almost positive that's Mrs. Cogs. I love her designs. I'm wanting to buy a couple more of her kits. The other side, which is another place for her to tuck stuff. She likes to tuck. She doesn't like to write. She likes to tuck. And so I took this paper here, which I think is, I think this is Nectar's Creations, but I could be wrong. But I had it in my bits and bobs, as her and Tina says. And I just sewed this here and made just, and then I just took a little notch out and just made it into a little envelope. And then I just added a bunch of vintage stuff for her that she can go through. It's like some notepad paper and some vintage recipe cards. And there's more stuff way down in there for her to have. Yeah, you know you've been binge watching Yvonne and Tina too much when you start using their lingo, bits and bobs and all this. Yeah. Okay, and see, here is one of my journaling cards that has wallpaper, the vintage wallpaper on it. And I tried the little crazy stitch looking thing. I'm not very good at it, but there's one of them. So that, and I like the colors with this journal, so I added that. And here's another piece of the vintage stationery that I had got in that haul. Just got a little kitty on it. So I added that in here. Is that in there right? There we go. And another one of the journaling cards that I made with the antique music paper and the piano roll. And just another journaling card and some more butterflies because she can never have enough butterflies. And then this is the other side of that vintage stationery that she can tuck something in. And look at this. Is this not gorgeous? This is that Ideals paper. And of course another tuck, and it was just so heavy I put a paper clip here. And this is all vintage ephemera. Here is some more wallpaper, which I don't think you can see very well. But it's really pretty pastel. She can do whatever she wants with it. She can cut it up, scan it, I don't care. Here is a vintage letter from 1944. This is another letter. So she has some ephemera. This is a Dutch. Is it Dutch? No, I don't remember. Page out of one of my books. I love to use that. And then here is a library card. Here's the card. I just put a little piece of that fabric. I love to do that at the top, and it is distressed around. This is a couple pieces of Tina's kit. I don't remember which one because it was in my little box. There's a paper doily, and I just added that pretty little heart. This is the rest of a piece of one of my favorite wallpapers. And then just a couple. This is from Tina's. That's a different kit. I've got so many of her kits that you start to forget the name of all the kits. This is vintage. This one is too, and I don't remember where I got this too. But this is a vintage, it's a type of calling card, but not a calling card, and I don't remember what they're called. But this is a vintage piece of stationery. Look at that, how cute. So I had to give her one of those. All this come from Stacy. I ordered all this from Stacy, who is Recycloves on Instagram. And there's a couple pieces of this, memo. It says memo, and it's just, lists, writing paper. And then these were two of my favorites, and they are vintage, bookmarks. Are those not adorable? But I'm cleaning out a lot of my stash, which I'll get into later. But I wanted to give her a couple of my favorite things that I had around here. So, that's what I did. And then some more lace. And then back here, I have one of these large pieces. And this, again, is from Diane Shawls, which is a mold barn door on Etsy. And I just made her a large journal card. This is so pretty. This is one of those vintage pieces of stationery. Isn't that pretty? And it's got a scripture at the bottom. I love the scalloped edge there. And then here's another one, which I know the apples don't really go, but it's still part of that haul, and I wanted to give her one of each so she would have one. I know she really liked it. And then here is a vintage catalog library card. And another one of Mrs. Cobb's, I do believe. That I have butterflies, another place to tuck. Okay, and here is my two favorite pieces of the vintage wallpaper that I have. And I gave them both to her. It's the only piece I had. And are these not absolutely stunning? Oh my gosh. Absolutely love them. They're my favorite. So that tells you, Yvonne, how much I love you. Girl, you gotta know now. Yeah, these are my favorite. I'm a pastel girl. But they just went with this journal. And I was like, I've got to just put them in there. I have to. So yeah, they just fit perfect in here. So those go. And then back here, look at that page. Isn't that pretty? Back here, another piece of vintage wallpaper. This is more vintage stationery. It's just so cute. Of course, what's funny, is she's got all this place to write, and she doesn't do writing. She doesn't, really do a lot of writing. But she can do whatever she wants with. She can scan it, this is some vintage stationery, and it has, an envelope. And she can pass it on if she wants. That's fine by me. This was the very first time I ever used my antique piano paper roll, and I love it. I need more of it. But I used some French printables, and then this, of course, is already made. Couldn't help it. It just went. But I made this cute little envelope here. There's nothing in it. But I made this envelope, and it goes to her. I just really love the way that turned out. This is a floating pocket, and inside here, there's just a journaling card, a couple I made, and then this is full of vintage playing cards. I'm not gonna pull that out. that just sits there. Then in the back, there is this pocket here with the fabric, like I said. Another large journaling card with that I've sewn around with the wallpaper. And, oops, I dropped that. Another guest check. Let me pick this up. Keep dropping stuff. I got dropsies. And then this dragonfly, of course you know where it comes from, postcard. And then there is two little poems. And, of course, I added the one that says the friend on here. Because Yvonne has been there for me a lot lately. To talk to me through some really, really tough times. And I really appreciate her. So, and she knows that. So thank you, Yvonne, for being there for me. And our long talks that we've had recently, I really appreciate you. So I hope you love this journal. As you can see, it's a chunky one. I will be getting this to you in the mail in the next couple days. And I hope that you enjoy it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will be coming back to you really soon with an update on my channel video. So I hope you guys have a blessed day, and I will see you soon. Bye.